Good morning, students. This is the part 2 for the chapter 5, MS Excel Formatting and Calculations. In the last class, we have studied how to format in the cells, how to change the row height, column, how to add row, how to add column, how to add a cell. These all things we have studied in the part 1. Now, in the part 2, we will study how to put borders in the cells or in a area. Then we will study how to put the background color. Then we will study the next, that is, what is the cell address, how we can operate in Excel, means how we can do the calculations in Excel. And then we will study what are the different type of errors in Excel. After that, this chapter will be ended. So we will start the first topic, that is how to put borders in a cell.
Borders is a built-in tool that lets users assess predefined border styles to add a border around two or more cells on a spreadsheet. You can add border to your cells in Excel worksheet. To add borders, what you have to do, first you have to just select the area where you want to put the border. Suppose I want to put the border here, I will select that area. Now, from the font group on the home tab, in your home tab, in the font group, click on the drop down arrow in your borders. The border drop down menu appears. Just can you see small button? Just click it. These are the borders drop down menu. You can select the border style you want. Like you want only bottom border, top border, left border, right border, no border, all borders, whatever type you want, you can use from here. Or else you can also draw the border. You can also draw the border grid. If you want to erase the border, you can do this. This is the line color. This is the line style. Then if you want more border, to add additional border style, you can go here. This will open the format cell dialog box with the border tab opens. So what type of border you want, like suppose directly I will go for the mode border. Can you see this format cells dialog box options? You can open it by clicking on the button located at the bottom of the right corner of the font group also. Can you see here? ये क्लिक करोगे तब भी ये ओपन होगा. ओके, दिस स्मॉल पॉइंट यू कैन सी, व्हेन यू क्लिक इट, दिस विल आल्सो ओपन अप. देन व्हाट टाइप ऑफ बॉर्डर यू वांट, यू कैन जस्ट सेलेक्ट. ओके, यू वांट आउटलाइन इनसाइड, यू जस्ट वांट आउटलाइन. ओके, वी विल गो विद द आउटलाइन फर्स्ट. देन व्हाट टाइप ऑफ कलर यू वांट, सपोज यू वांट रेड मैरून. ओके, click on OK. Can you see? Okay, suppose you want another type of border. Suppose you want to draw the border. Can you see your mouse pointer changes to a pencil? You just click here and start drawing border. Suppose ye galat ho gaya, just go here, take the eraser and just click it and your border will be easier. See, if you want double click it, it will be removed from the your eraser will be removed. Suppose you want again, suppose you want this, just go here, right click. Can you see here all borders? See, okay. Okay, this is what I have done. This is the background color. You can fill colors in all or any selected cells of the worksheet. Just select the cell and from font group under the home tab, click on the drop down arrow of the fill color option. This is what is your fill color option. The color menu appears and select the color you want. Suppose suppose I want the heading to be different, so I will just select it and I will change the color. Okay, you can put different colors in the different cells. You can put different colors for the different cells also. One color, whenever, whatever you select the area, you can change its color with the help of this fill color. The next is the cell address. It is quite significant to understand the concept of the cell address. There are 17 billion cells in a single worksheet. We need to assign an address to every cell in order to differentiate from others. Suppose in your class also, there are many persons with the same name. So how we can identify by their roll numbers, because they have a different roll numbers. So like that, if you want to find out any particular cell in this 17 billion cell, matlab ek sheet mein 17 billion cell hote hain, to hum har ek cell ko kaise pehchante hain? With the help of their cell address. So what is the cell address? When the row and the column, means ye jo line dikh rahi hai aapko, ye row ki line hai, ye column ki line hai, jab ye do lines intersect hoti hain, means ek dusre ko jab cut karti hain, they make a box. That we call it as a cell. तो इस particular cell का नाम होगा, इस particular cell का नाम होगा, इस particular cell का नाम होगा. जो ये नाम होता है particular cells का, they are known as cell address. When the row and the column intersect each other, they form a cell address. Like for example, ये A है, ये 1 है, तो इसका नाम क्या हुआ? A1. This is B1. This is C1, this is D1. वैसे ही suppose ये A है, ये 2 है, then this cell is known as A2, A3, A4, A5. So this is how your cell address goes. You see here, okay, this is the name box where the cell name is given. Wherever you keep its cell name is given here. Okay, D8, I19, K16. M18. So this name box shows the cell address of any cell. Therefore, the cell address of the first and the last cell in MS Excel 2013 are A1, means your first cell name is A1 and the last cell name is XFD 1048 57. Okay, you can just write down here the last cell name, that is XFD 1048 57 6. Can you see here? This is your last cell of this worksheet. If you want to directly go to the first, just write down here in the name box A1. You will be in the first cell. So cell address assist while using formulas. Excel saves the formula using cell address and thereby helps you to alter the content of the cell. Excel automatically changes the content of the formula cell on the foundation of the new data. We are going to study now, that is the operations in Excel. Operations in, first of all we will tell know what are operations in mathematics. Mostly the arithmetic operators, like what you use in mathematics, multiplication, division, addition, subtraction, or a power sign. Mostly you don't know the power, that is 2 to the power 2 means 2 will be multiplied by itself by 2 times, or 2 to the power 3 means 2 will be multiplied by itself 3 times. This is what a power does. Rest, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, you all know this. These are the arithmetic operations which are used in Excel also to do the calculations. So these are the operators in Excel, what you use. Multiplication kya karte hain, aapko pata hai. It multiplies two numbers, two or more numbers. Addition, it add two or more numbers. Like that we have division also, we have subtraction and a power. Now, operators precedence, or you can call the order of the operators. Like we have the order, okay, ye aayega pehle, fir wo aayega, like that. These are the orders, we call it. सो ऑर्डर्स इन ऑपरेटर, ऑपरेटर्स हैं मल्टीप्लिकेशन, डिवीजन, सब्सट्रैक्शन, मल्टीप्लिकेशन और ब्रैकेट और यू कॉल पावर. तो इन सब में से आप पहले किसको कैलकुलेट करेंगे? ब्रैकेट. ओके, ऑर्डर, व्हाट वी कॉल इन मैथमेटिक्स, वी गिव इट एज अ वर्ड मास रूल. ओके, बी फॉर ब्रैकेट, ओ फॉर ऑर्डर और ऑर्डर, और वी कॉल इट पावर ऑल्सो. डी फॉर डिविजन, मल्टीप्लीकेशन, देन एडिशन एंड देन सब्सट्रैक्शन. सो दिस इज़ नोन एज बोर्ड मास रूल विच यू फॉलो इन मैथमेटिक्स. द सेम रूल फॉलोज गोज़ विद द एक्सेल ऑल्सो. ओके, जैसे हम वहाँ का ऑपरेटर्स यूज़ करते हैं, मैथमेटिक्स ऑपरेटर्स यूज़ करते हैं, एडिशन सब्सट्रैक्शन, लाइक दैट इन एक्सेल ऑल्सो वी यूज़ द सेम ऑपरेटर्स. सो जहाँ जैसा रूल आपके मैथमेटिक्स में होता है वैसा ही रूल हम एक्सेल में भी अपनाते हैं, दैट इज़ बोर्ड मास रूल. Now, how we can do the calculation? We can do the calculation with the help of the numbers, and we can here, we can use the cell address for doing the calculations also. So, here we go with the calculations. The next thing we are going to study is calculations. For doing the calculation, we do not need any calculator here. To make Excel understand that you want to do a calculation, is it has always to be started with an equal to sign or else a plus sign. I will write here equal to. If you want to do any type of calculation, that is addition, subtraction, multiplication or division, suppose you want to add two numbers. Suppose I write down here 680 plus 492, enter. Okay, it automatically gives you the numbers. Or else suppose you write here plus sign, plus 78 plus 59, enter. Okay, suppose you want to do the multiplication, equals to 45 into 96, enter. Okay, so this is how we can do the calculations in Excel. When you press the enter key, the formula will be replaced by its result and the cell will show the result. Suppose I will write with the help of the cell address. Suppose I will add this, this and this. I will write equals to, I will click here D2 plus D3 plus D4 and enter. Okay, can you see here? This is what is the equals to of it. Suppose I change this number, I write down here 45. Can you see 5537? The total has been changed. Suppose I write down 2. Can you see 1219? Okay. Suppose these are very big numbers, so suppose I write down 5. See 52. 5. 12. Suppose I change it to 5. 15. So it keeps on changing by itself because I have used the formula. I have used the address, cell address of this. The final result will be shown in the contents of the cell, which has the formula. Okay. If you calculate a complicated operation, like for example, suppose I put the number 72, 96, then 4, then 3 and 6. Suppose I put these numbers and I will put here equals to this plus this into this to the power this and divided by E and enter. Can you see the answer? Okay, so whenever you put here, you can see the formula. This is the formula bar, A1 plus B1, this formula you can see here. And when you click, you can see this. Okay, this is how we can do the calculations in Excel. Now, why we get the errors? If Excel cannot calculate a formula that you have entered in a cell, it displays an error value. in the cell as soon as you complete the formula and press enter. Excel uses several error values which are shown with the hash sign. In the later, I will let you see. Can you see here? With the hash sign means that is an error. Hash sign ke baad jo bhi hash sign agar aata hai aapke Excel mein means you have done any mistake there. The next, there are some errors means, can you see this error means anything divisible by zero. Okay, cannot be divided by zero. So, the division operation in your formula refers to that the cell contains the value zero or is blank. Can you see here in the formula what I have written means divisible by 7 and 7 there is nothing, means it's 0, so it is showing you the error. Another type of error is hash name question mark. This error value appears when you type a non-numeric value in a cell or a formula. Suppose I write down here name. See, hash value, okay, means there is no value, there is no, 8 cannot be divided by any alphabet, so it is telling you hash value. There is hash num also. That error can be used for an invalid content in an Excel formula that produces a number too large or too small to be represented in a worksheet. Suppose hash value ki jagah hash num hai, it means that या तो वो नंबर बहुत बड़ा है या तो नंबर बहुत छोटा है किसी चीज़ से ऐड या मल्टीप्लाई या डिवीजन करने के लिए. नेक्स्ट इज हैश रेफरेंस आल्सो REF करके आता है एक. इट मींस दैट दैट टाइप ऑफ एरर ओनली ऑकर्स व्हेन यू डिलीट अ सेल रिपोर्ट. सपोज यहाँ तक ठीक था. सपोज मैं इसको डिलीट कर देती हूँ फार्मूला को. ओके अब ठीक है फार्मूला. ओके सपोज ये है फॉर्मूला में ना. ओके सपोज मैं इसको डिलीट कर देती हूँ, ये सेल को ही डिलीट कर देती हूँ. सी हैश रेफरेंस. ओके मैंने जो फॉर्मूला में डाला है सेल और उस सेल को ही मैंने डिलीट कर दिया. सो दिस टाइप ऑफ एरर यू विल गेट. Now this is the end of this particular MS Excel chapter, that is formatting and calculations in Excel. So in this particular chapter what we have studied, that is it is given in the let's recall point. Excel enables you to select various cells, rows and columns using the mouse and the keyboard as well. Okay, aapko agar select karna hai aapko cell, rows, columns, you can select it with the help of both mouse and keyboard. The next we have studied, that is Excel gives various formatting options like alignment, merging, orientation, wrapping of the text, font size, font color, and even you can put the borders and the colors in your cells. Next we have studied how we can arrange the text also, that is right alignment, left alignment, middle alignment, centered alignment, top alignment, bottom alignment. These are the six alignment we have studied. Then we have studied how we can merge two or more cells, how we can merge the cells, how we can unmerge the cells, how we can delete the cell, how we can add the cell, or how we can delete and add both the rows and columns, how we can delete also the rows and columns. These all we have studied. How we can set the row height, column width, or how we can auto fit it. So these all things we have studied. Then we have studied how we can format in the cells. Then we have studied how we can change the cell background, and how we can do the calculations in Excel. These are the just recall points for your this chapter. So this is the end of the chapter. In the next class we will do the exercise.